All right, well, as you can see, we've got the control panel here for the MK4 machine, and we're going to go through and get it all cleaned up. I'm not going to do the sides or the actual case because that'll be done on the cabinet restoration part, which I'll show later. But since my switcher is supposed to be here today, I figure it's a good time to go ahead and get started on things. So this will just be the control panel rebuild and clean up. The actual frame and all of this stuff will be done later because it needs a lot of work. You can see here that I mentioned before, you saw in the first part where I was showing the cabinet, there's nails on the side. Someone put nails on the side of this thing. There's one here and one there and one there and one up here. And because that's at some point somebody decided to break off this side of the panel and they glued it back in place, which is fine. But they also decided to put some nails in here. And when they nailed in these bottom two pieces, it pushed over this part and it just comes right off. It should be over here in the corner like it is over on this side. Wedged up in here as a reinforcement for the side and the bottom. So somebody decided to put the nails in here. When they hammered them in there, just pushed this out of the way and bent over the I think they're called brads. Bent those over. So that'll have to be repaired. I'm not going to do it here. I'll do it when I do the cabinet restoration part of this. So, well, I say restoration, but I mean cleanup. I'm not a purist anymore. This is likely going to end up going back in the arcade at some point. So I'm not going to go complete balls to the wall when it comes to restoration. For instance, over here, there's a chunk missing out of the corner of it. I'm just going to kind of touch this up. I'm not going to really worry about wood filler and sanding because I'm not going to replace all the art. Because like I say, I may pull these nails out and just kind of do some touch-up. But this may end up going back in the public. And I don't really want to mess with the full-blown restoration because it'll just get messed up again. So... there we go. All right, so we're just going to concentrate for this instance on the top part. So there's one thing here. These are the IL sticks as opposed to the HAP. And the original stick that was on player two side was the smaller shaft. Original was the HAP one with the smaller shaft. And I did not want to have to replace, take all the buttons out and the Lexan off and the control panel overlay off and all the stuff to part to change out the dust washer. So I kind of had to hack it up here. So you can see here, it's kind of all hacked up in a square. It's hard to see. But just to get the joystick through the smaller radius dust washer for the smaller HAP control. And you can see how there's dust and all the and crap and contaminants and all kinds of crap underneath the Lexan here. And of course, the cigarette burn patina on the start buttons. Pardon me, the rusty security screws. I got all new security screws, got new Lexan. The buttons and joysticks are all new. I put those in before we opened up the arcade. But the switches are replaced and so are the joysticks. So everything is good to go as far as all this is concerned. I just need to get the Lexan changed out and get the CPO cleaned up. And then the T-molding, I may end up going with yellow T-molding just to see how it looks. Don't chastise me too early. I may end up going with yellow just to see how it works, but I have black in reserve. So we're also going to this piece here. It's in really good shape, but it is kind of rusting underneath. So I'm going to sand this down and paint it. Again, this will be part of the cabinet cleanup. This video will just be for this part. So I'm going to actually disconnect the panel from the box by taking the nuts off of here for the hinge, and then we'll just set this part aside and worry about this piece here. So let's get our tools here. And I believe they are 11:32, if memory serves. Oh, one's missing. Well, that's always nice. This one usually has two because it bonds the ground strap to the control panel. So for the time being, we can just consider that one to go on over here. Before I do that, let's take this out of here. Alright, now this should come apart from the box somewhat easily. There we go. Alright. Set that aside. Move this. Okay. Now we can work unfettered on the panel. So the first step is to get the joysticks out so it can sit flat. To do that, of course, we got to pull our C-clips. So in order to do that, we will need to spin it around this way. There we go. And move it around to the edge, push this down, grab it, and just take it off. Just like that. Very easy. Then we'll take this off. And out it comes. Set it aside. They've got some play. You can see kind of some dirty in there and dust, but I'm not going to change them out because they're still relatively new. Now this side as well. We'll spin the stick around. Push it down. Take it out. Now normally you really don't have to take these plastic parts off, but I do because I don't want a lot of times you'll turn this around and this will fall out and you'll lose it down inside the machine or whatever. So I take those off, I just out of habit. Alright, and there's the second stick. So moving right along here. Alright. Okay. So the first step really, you can really kind of see the rust building up under here. I want to sand all this down and fix that. So, alright, so there we have the panel now. And I guess what we can do, I guess I'll probably turn it back around and we'll take all of our wiring harness off. Because the buttons all have to come out. Let's zoom back out here and we'll grab a Sharpie. Not too Sharpie, gotta be safe. And we'll have to label these. So let's see here. If I can write on these, we'll just do HK, LK, B, LK, Balaki. You hear Balaki? All right. HP, LP, run. Two P. One P. H K. L K. B L K. H P. LP, run. All right, so I'm not going to mark the wires for the joysticks. I'll just get the manual out and find out what those are supposed to be later when I go to hook them back up, because I don't have anything to write on like I do the switch. I write on these to make it easier when I go to put it back together. But when it comes to the wiring, I mean, the grounds are obvious. There's only four wires, so I'll go to look it up later. Just easier that way. It takes less time to just look it up than it does to label them all. Okay, now that's out. Let's set that aside. All right, now what I really recommend is getting yourself a button wrench. And it looks like this. This makes your job a lot easier. So in this instance, we can just use this like a big nut driver, and you just loosen them all up. This also helps keep them from spinning and moving when people smash on them, and over time they loosen up. This will help prevent that if you've got one of these. This just makes life so much easier. That was fun. Took a chunk of flesh out. You can still see it sitting on the the switch. Well, it happens. Yeah, got some blued. Got some blued showing here. That's my blued. So now I can say I put my blood and sweat in here. Probably not tears, but the job's not over yet. Okay, set that there. Now we can spin all these out. This is all the work you have to go through if you ever change your joysticks and you have to replace the dust washers. You got to go through all this just to do that. So that's why. You'll see when I get to take the CPO off, how I butchered that dust washer to make it fit. Like I say, I'm not trying to win any beauty contests or any kind of restoration awards, because this is likely going to go back into the arcade at some point. But since it had to come out, I figured it'd be a good video to do for multi-project, just so I can finally get back to playing some MK since I have a machine at the house now. It was like that. I didn't do that. It was like that before. I didn't do it. No one saw me do it. You can't prove anything. Okay, buttons are out. Let's get our, I think this is 3/8. Nope. 11/32 for the lot. All right, where's my deal? So let's get the CPO nuts off the stands here. You don't have to remove the joysticks. It might be a good idea to do so. And now that I think about it, I'll probably go ahead and do that just so this will lay flat. Okay. Alright, that should be all of the studs. So the CPO should be able to come off now. But we'll go ahead and take the joysticks off. No reason not to, it won't take but a minute or so. Okay, we'll set this aside. And then we'll take our spacers and set them aside. Okay, I think that's about it. Let's turn this back around. And let's remove our security screws. Let's grab this, and it should be this size here. Indeed it is. Put this away. Man. That one was in there. Now the CPU doesn't necessarily have to come out, but I want to take it out to clean underneath it, and I also want to replace this dust washer. You can see from this side what I mean. I had to take a knife and cut it up to get the... Originally it was a much smaller diameter one for the smaller diameter joystick, but this it wouldn't fit. The IL one wouldn't fit, so I had to hack it up. So I want to change that out, so the CPU has to come out for that. And since it has to come out for that, I might as well clean underneath it. So. Oh, I always go the wrong way. I'm 100% on that. Okay. Let's keep going with this. I think this machine spent time in a bar because this is somewhat yellowed, and it's obviously because of the cigarette burns and how rusty it is. Okay, all right, let's take this off slowly. You gotta be careful because sometimes if someone spills junk underneath here, it'll pull up the artwork and the ink off the CPU when you do this. So you wanna go somewhat slow and don't just rip it off. Okay, that was successful. And you can see the discoloration on this. Well, maybe you can't. Yeah, see around here. It's just been on there so long. And it's really, you can see it around. It goes all the way around here. You know, of course, this corner here, something. And over here is the same story. But it's nothing that I can't clean off with some cleaner. But before we do that, let's lift this off. And it should just come right out. Sometimes it needs some persuasion. Did I get all of the... I got all the screws. There we go. Push it from the bottom side. There it is. Yep, just as I suspected. This has seen better days. Here's that dust washer. Yep. I had to do what I had to do to get it to fit. Otherwise, I would have had to do all this work just to change this out, and no one likes that. So you see a lot of people, you know, replace joysticks and all that jazz, and they just have the dust washer on top of the CPU. This is why. They don't want to have to go through all this work just to replace this, because there is a little cutout here, so it's supposed to be underneath the CPU, but it's a lot of work to do that. So you'll see them a lot of times just put them on the top. But, you know, they have to get the old one out. the only way to get the old one out is to do this. So I'm really kind of puzzled. Maybe they don't realize it, but I don't know. The people you see put the dishwashers on top of the CPL, I don't understand their logic, but anyway. So now I can replace probably both of them. This has tape on it for some reason. Don't know why that is, but so I'll go down to my stash and try and find some new ones. I don't think I have any red ones because the IL sticks come with the same color. These came with the red dust washers, so I don't think I still have them here at the house. They're probably at the business, so for the sake of getting this done, I'll just use black ones. But let's grab some cleaner here, and I don't think I have... Hang on, I have to go grab a microfiber towel out of the garage. Give me a moment here. All right, so let's just spray this down. And we'll give it a good wipe. Yeah, so the metal on the back side of the CPO has kind of turned these areas white, but not a big deal. So, all right, that's sufficient enough for me. Now, let's set this aside for a moment. And let's do, this is nice. Got debris everywhere. You guys hear about the cheese factory in Paris that exploded? Yeah, there was nothing left but debris. All right. So we'll give this a good wipe down. And I'm using this car, Meguiar's Quick Detailer, because it doesn't have ammonia in it. Windex has ammonia, and I don't trust it when it comes to artwork and things like that. So I just use that Quick Detailer, works pretty well. Okay, that seems all right. Let's turn them back around this way. Now the real fun begins here. Let's see if we can bring this back to life. Oh yeah, that comes right off. What about this corner here? This come right off? Let's zoom in here. Whoa, there we go. Not quite as easy as the other corner, but it does appear to be successful. Okay, so let's zoom back out again. Oh, always wrong. There we go. It's always wrong because my camera's upside down filming from overhead. So it gets confusing. I have to sit there and either try and remember which way to turn it or just do 50-50 and I'm always wrong. So touch is done to this. And we're looking good here. Okay. Now, let's take a look at our original Lexan, because it's in pretty rough shape. yeah. So it's time, obviously, for a new piece, and we just happen to have one. All right, here we go. This comes courtesy of Mr. Jeff West at XL Arcade. If you guys need anything MK related, he is a great asset to have at your disposal, at all of our disposals. So, got a brand new one, and it's professionally packaged. It's got the staples in it and everything. So, let's see if we can just pull this apart. Should be able to. I say that, but I'm a puny weakling. There we go. There you have it. Brand new. Awesome. It's got all the factory location holes for the security screws and everything, so this should turn out nice and good. Let us bring this back over, and we shall peel off this. Now, this is going to have a static buildup on it when you do this, so what I recommend is taking your static off, and with one side still having the protection on it on the opposite side, let's go through here and clean it, because that'll get rid of the static buildup. I forgot about that. All right, so we'll spray this down. Very lightly, so you get rid of the streaks. I'm gonna flip it over to the dry side and do the same thing. Okay, now give it a quick. Now it should be much easier to install here. Let's see if I can figure this out. All right, so there we go. Nope, I got it backwards, which is fine. We'll just give the same treatment to this side. You can hear it. Well, I did. You can hear the static on it. So the only real way to do it is to clean it. So we'll turn it around this way. Man, it's real staticky. I just found this is the kind of the best way to do it. I need to get a new towel. This one's too dirty. Hang on. All right, brand new towel. Let's do this again just real quick. And this is the side that I think this is the side that's exposed. I walked away for too long. I'm getting too old. Okay, that should be fine. And yeah, that's the side that's exposed. So our important side is this side. Okay. Very lightly. So we can get rid of the streaks and the fingerprints. And there we go. All right, so now it's time to put this on here. And let's. Okay. Oh, is this upside down again? This is upside down again, okay. All right, there we go. Awesome. So, sweetness. Let's get our security screws. All right, brand new, 100 of them. Let's Let's get our driver. Well, that's no good. Huh. I think I'm screwed here. No pun intended. Well, no, they're the same size. For some reason, that one didn't seem to... Oh. No wonder. I'm a total dolt. There's no wood underneath this. Oh, my Lord. Oh. I'm getting senile in my old age. I'm a nut. All right. So, well, not worry about this for now then. Just brain farted that. We'll set this aside. We'll get this back up here. And then before I put this back on, I need to go get a couple of new dust washers. So again, one moment. Sorry. Anyway, I got two nice good replacements. We'll put that one there and that one there. And then we'll set this back in place. Right back on. So now, I guess to secure it, what we'll do is I will attach the nuts back in place here for the CPO. You bastard. Well, you stay in there. How about that? Oh, I've never done something so difficult in my life. What's going on here? There we go. Okay. Let's loosen this up again because I need to shift it over a bit. Alright, so there's that. Let's turn this back over now. Put this in place. Does it look okay? Yeah. Everything seems good. Now we can put in our security screws. Herpa-dirt on that one. And like anything, never ever tighten the screws until you get all of them started and in place, because you'll really be hating life if you have to go back and unscrew them all over again because you tighten them down and the last one won't go in. And you don't ever want to do these with a power tool because you'll strip out the hole if you over torque it, and then you won't be able to ever get it to be tight again unless you put some wood glue down in the hole or something, or a toothpick. That's a little trick of the trade. If your hole is stripped out and your wood, put a toothpick in there, cut it off flat, and then put your screw in. It'll go right back in like it was never bad.
(Clears throat)
That's the problem with some of these. Some of these you screw down and they bow out. See how it's bowed out there? Sometimes if that happens, you have to loosen all these back up and shift it around a bit, unfortunately. Or you can just kind of take this back out a bit till it's flat. Or we can hold it down while we tighten it. Well, that works too. So you got rid of it somewhat. Hold it down while you're tightening it. Because it's not 100% perfect, but it's about 99.9%. Okay, that's good. No more bow on that. All right. I just realized that I say all right after everything I do. Just habit. I'm sorry. All right. I don't know why I didn't realize that till just now. All right. I just did it again. Okay. We're done with this. I need to get a new transition phrase. Well, hot dog. How about that one? Okay. So there we have it. Now it's time to reassemble, and that should finish this up. Okay. Well, first things first, I guess we will do the buttons. Let's throw these in. Stay in there. All right. So let's start threading these on. It's going to be off camera here for the moment. Sorry. All right. High punch. I need this side to stay in. Low punch. Block. Little kick. And run. Okay, now we can do this side. Okay, so trying to tighten these up by hand is going to be almost impossible. You can tighten them down, but they'll never be truly tight. So that's where the button wrench comes in handy. And when you set these up, you want to have the taller tab of the button facing this way. You want to kind of angle them all to where they're to the back. Let's go this way. Something like this, because the actual button, the wires come out towards the tall end. They're short end, the tall end. The wires actually come out the end with the tall end, so you want to have them angled to where they don't interfere with each other. So this is about the kind of, this is about the layout you want to have when you're tightening these buttons up. So it should look something just like this. Yeah, it should look like that, where they're angled away from each other so they clear when you put them in. All right. I just said all right again. I don't know why I'm doing that. It is what it is. We all have our quirks. Let's do that. Hot diggity. Can I say hot diggity instead of all right? Okay. That's good to go. Let's back out here again. Let's get our joysticks put in. Where did my screwdriver go? There's that. Let's put these back on. Well, you know what I just did? I forgot to put the spacers in. Fortunately, if you're lucky, you can get the spacers to pop through the dust washer. If we're lucky. Well, that was nice and easy on that one. And we're not so lucky on this one. That's all right. So let's turn it back around. I herpaderped on that one too. There we go. Okay. Let's toss all these out. Now we can put our sticks in. There's that one. And there's that one. And what we have to do again is get our C-clip on here. I always like to make sure it's on all the way. That's good. That's good. All right, well, let's get our wiring harness back on. Is that? Yeah, that should be correct. Isn't it? Yeah, I think that's correct. Should be this. Layer one. Unless I have that wrong. Nope, that's all right. Layer one. We've got Balaki. We've got Run. Little Punch. And I realize now that I told you completely backwards. The short end has the wires coming out, not the long end, but it'll still work. I messed that up. I'm sorry. Okay. Shouldn't make any difference, though. Okay, high kick. You think I'd know doing this so many times, but, you know, like I say, I'm brain farting in my old age. Two players start. Did I do that one backwards? I sure did. Gosh dang it. There we go. Okay. Now these, it does matter, because if these are the other way, you won't be able to shut it. It'll hit the wood on this end of the start buttons. But the rest of these shouldn't matter at all. Okay, purple wires are gonna be this side. Okay, we've got high kick over here. We've got high punch. Run. Low punch. Low kick. And block. Okay. Put that in there. Now, we've got these wires here for player two and player one. Let's get this in there. Again, I'm just going off of length here because it should be self-explanatory based on wire length. But I will look it up and verify at a later time. It's not a big deal. For the purposes of this video, it doesn't matter. All right. That doesn't seem right. That seems more correct this way. With any luck, this will be correct and I won't have to change anything. All right, well there it is. All wired back up, all back together. Let's turn this around. And there you have it. Restored control panel. Well, there it is. Not too terribly difficult. Sorry for the mistakes, but that's what you get when you you know, go through this and post an unedited video. I don't like to do the jump cuts, and you know, when I watch people's videos where every 5 seconds there's a jump cut and a jump cut and a jump cut, that just kind of bugs me. So I don't mind doing a rather longer video, as long as you guys don't mind it. And I avoid all the jump cuts and I leave my mistakes in. I don't care. I'm not out to impress anybody. And my production quality isn't that fantastic. I'm not, like I say, not an award-winning type of deal. It would be nice to learn some editing skills and software and do different things, but that's not what I'm about. I'm about the end result, not the stuff in between, the fluff, if you will. So there it is. Stay tuned for the next part where we get the cabinet cleaned up and restored along with the control panel box. And like I say, my switcher should be here today, and that will be the last piece I'm waiting on, and we can get started with the rest of the project. So thanks for watching and stay tuned.